Filipino-American Ella Fajardo is set to play for Division I school Farley Dickinson University in New Jersey. She is set to max out her playing years in the U.S. NCAA, but she still dreams of representing and playing in the Philippines. And Ella now joins us on ANC. So Ella, hello, and tell us about this process, about committing to FDU, and how was it like?
I'm still in contact with my coaches very much, but I'm not really allowed to see them as it is the dead period. But once that is over, I'm looking to get back on campus again just to get the feel of things. And they are also looking to see me as well. And I'm also looking to see my teammates in my class as well.
Now, Ella, just a little bit of background or a little bit of a context for our viewers. When you talk about NCAA Division I schools, we're so used to the Dukes, the North Carolinas, the Stanfords, etc. But then FDU is a relatively not so known school right here in the Philippines. But can you tell us about this decision? Still a Division I school, of course, but how will this be a big impact for your career?
Well, what definitely attracted me to FDU was the relationship that I built with the team, especially the head coach and the assistant coach. They're both relatively new. It's gonna be their third season when I'm playing with them, and they came from Fordham University, so they have some coaching background over there. But basically, they are adding a new culture and a new environment into FDU, which is why they're kind of really rebuilding the program, starting with my class. So they went to me and they said, hey, we really need your leadership, and we don't care what size you are. We know that you're going to fit right in. So that really attracted me to the school, and not to mention that it's only about 10 minutes away from my house, so it's really useful, especially in this time during the pandemic. I still get to be close with my family.
How did that play a big decision? Of course, can you expand more on that, on being close to family as a major part of your decision to commit?
Right. Well, I'm a very family-oriented person, and that's also the vibe that I got from FDU. Like, they're always doing stuff together on and off the court, and you know, every time I made phone calls with them, they'd ask how my family was, how my sisters were, who also play basketball, and my family loves to watch my games, so I'm sure that they'll be there every single home game. So they were like, please, please choose Farley Dickinson because we want to watch your games all the time. So that was definitely a huge factor.
Can you tell us through the process of the mind or the state of a recruit, just like you, when you're coming in from high school and going into college? It's usually you want to go, there's actually an option, right? So you want to go to like big schools with winning programs, as opposed to rebuilding programs, etc. And something, what is that like in your decision? Why did you choose this path to be able to be part of a rebuilding process instead of, you know, a winning program?
Mm-hmm. Well, like I said, the family part, I think, was a huge portion of it. I know big schools, they have a lot of recruits, and FDU had a lot of recruits as well, but I feel like it's on a more personal level, and they really treat you as their kid, so that was definitely a huge factor. And I don't know, just, I guess that's the Filipino part of me, like the very family oriented. It's like I kind of, it was perfect. It honestly really was perfect. And as an athlete who is still in high school, I still have one more year of playing time. There were times where I did feel overwhelmed with, you know, the schools that I had. And a lot of the times I'd like write it down, the pros and cons, and the pros kind of just kept adding up for FDU, really.
All right. So FDU is the place to go, and I'm wishing you well on your first year. And hopefully COVID really will really be gone for,
right,
of course, at least American sports to be on full display, especially the NCAA. And now, of course, Ella, you also had your experience playing for the Philippines in the under 18 3x3 teams. Tell us about that experience. How did playing for that team help you grow as a player?
Okay, so last year when I played in the FIBA Asia Cup and the FIBA World Cup 3x3 U18, hands down, my most favorite moments ever. I mean, I didn't mention this before, but I used to go to the Philippines actually every single year when I was younger, because my whole dad's family's there, and they've supported me in my journey for the longest time since I played basketball. And I stopped in like the seventh grade, because that's when things started to get even more competitive and we were finding high schools for me to play in. So I had to be at those tournaments. It was too important for me to miss. And it's kind of funny looking back because it's like basketball brought me back to my homeland again and to play for my homeland even. So all that hard work, all that time that I missed, that I should have been in the Philippines, but I was here playing to find a really good high school to prepare me for college. It really paid off. So, you know, playing for my country, I'd like to thank my family, my dad's side, because it's like, I knew that if I secured a spot, I'd be able to see my family again. So I'm really looking forward to going to the Philippines again and seeing my family, but definitely, you know, playing for Gilas has developed such a sense of nationalism within me as, you know, a Filipino American. And just the culture of the Philippines and everything. I want to live there someday. I know it. After I finish my career here in the U.S., I really want to bring my knowledge to the Filipinos and give back to the youth.
Well, speaking of that, the WNBL has gone pro. It's been all over the news this past couple of weeks. And I want to get your thoughts on that. I know I've read up on articles that you want eventually to play in the women's pro league here. So can you tell us through your thoughts on playing for the WNBL?
Oh, for sure. I'm so excited about it. And I'm so happy that it's finally happening because, you know, I practice with the Gilas women's team every day in preparation for the 3x3 tournaments. And, you know, they want to keep on playing as much as possible, and especially to have that platform and even the financial aid that they'll get from there. You know, we love basketball and we want to showcase it, and we put so much hard work that I feel people don't really see, or the exposure that we really need in the Philippines. So hopefully after my career here in the U.S., like I said, I can go back to the Philippines and play in the WNBL or maybe even coach.
Well, okay, so before we go into coaching, I just want to get your thoughts also, Ella. Before this news broke out, what goes on through the mind of a women's player? Of course, when you're in high school, you're in college, especially that not a lot of opportunities are given to women's players in the pro ranks, right? But how did that shift when you found out that there's going to be a pro league? What goes on through the mind of an aspiring player, you know, to consider this as a career?
Right. Well, I think that me playing for the Philippine team was really a boost in my motivation, especially like getting all this support really from the youth, especially the youth, but everyone in the Philippines. I felt like that was an extra push, like, you know, keep going, keep playing for us, you know, like representing them. So I think that played a aspect. And after the news broke out that there was a WNBL, it was kind of like, finally, you know, like our hard work is really paying off, and that gives me even more motivation to keep going, keep grinding. And honestly, I feel very humbled getting a lot of messages from aspiring girls who want to play basketball, who's like, you know, sometimes they don't have shoes or sometimes they don't have the equipment necessary. And it's like, all I can tell them is I'm going to play for you and I'm going to give back to you. So like I said before, trying to hester all my knowledge here and hopefully bring it back to the Philippines and, you know, to help these kids out. That's really a dream of mine.
Well, not a lot of players, especially at a young age, you know, realize that they want to coach eventually after their playing careers. But now you're realizing it, Ella, and someday that's your goal. What is it in you that makes you want to coach?
I think maybe seeing my sister. I have a younger sister who plays basketball, and you know, I know that I'm going to be a part of her journey. You know, we live in the same house. We went to the same middle school, and just seeing her grow, I love that. And you know, that's something that I think that I'm going to take with me the rest of my life. And I love learning from other people as well. So I hope that I can do that and be like Coach Pat. Actually, Coach Pat is one of the best mentors I've had. Coach Julie is one of the best mentors I've had. And you know, because of basketball, they've traveled the world, they've seen it all, and they've been in so many different experiences that I hope I can only dream of, you know, experiencing myself.
What is it in Coach Pat, that you saw in him that you consider him as one of your great coaches?
I'd say that it's just how much he cares for me, you know, like he sees me as a daughter, but he really pushes me to the best of his abilities, to the best of my abilities. And I'm the kind of person, honestly, that it's like, if you shout out me, I'm going to take the criticism. And I know that it's just because you care about me. And that's really the type of coach Pat is. He's hard. And he knows what he wants, and honestly, what he wants is to win. And whenever we listen to him, we win. So I just know that he has so much experience, but he, above all that, he has so much love for his players. And, you know, we're all like daughters to him, and he looks out for us. He takes care of us. And he's definitely someone that, you know, has believed in me from the start.
Now, in your opinion, Ella, how should or how will women's basketball grow in countries like the Philippines, where it is not that big yet? Right? Mm-hmm. Philippines is just an example, and I'm sure other nations also have this kind of situation, same kind of situation. What is it in that, from your thoughts?
I think, honestly, it's just the lack of support. Us Filipina athletes right now, we're putting in the work, we're putting in the grind on the court. It's really just to get as many people to watch as possible. So really, I reach out to anyone who's watching this, who hasn't watched women's basketball yet, to watch it, to give it a try, and you'll see how much you're going to like it. But as of the female athletes, just keep working hard, because we really are working hard.
All right. So there you have it. Ella Fajardo right here on ANC. Stay safe and God bless.
Thank you. God bless you too.